Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. And this afternoon I watched the 2024 action film Roadhouse, which is a remake of the 1989 cult classic Roadhouse, starring Patrick Swayze, Kelly Lynch, Sam Elliott, and it has appearances by one of my musical heroes, blues guitar legend Jeff Healey, who sadly passed away in 2008 to cancer. This one stars Jake Gyllenhaal as a former UFC fighter. You also have Daniela Melchior, who I last saw in 2021's The Suicide Squad. You also have Conor McGregor. I can't stand the bugger. He is an actual UFC fighter. You have J.D. Pardo, Arturo Castro, and Billy Magnussen. So in this film, you have Jake Gyllenhaal playing former UFC fighter Elwood Dalton. In flashbacks, you get to see that he stopped being a UFC fighter because in a fight that he had with a friend of his who's also a UFC fighter, when he got hit in the head, he lost control of his rage and he became extremely angry, and he beat up his opponent so badly that he died in the ring. So he is traumatized by it, and he is not wanting to go back into UFC. So he currently makes a living scamming fighters on the underground circuit. As soon as he shows up and they see that's him, they don't want to fight him, and therefore he tends to earn the winnings basically without having to do anything. He's approached by Frankie, this lady who is a owner of what she says is a unruly roadhouse in the Florida Keys, the community of Glass Key. And she says she needs a head bouncer for a few weeks because there's an unruly element in the town. Initially he doesn't want to go, but after a half-hearted attempt at suicide where his car is smashed into by a train, he decides to take her up on the offer and go to the place. He starts off with making friends with Charlie, who's a teenager who runs the local bookstore, along with her father Stephen. As soon as he reaches there, he is put to work because there's this motorcycle gang who works for the local crime boss named Ben Brandt, and he basically beats the crap out of them and then takes them to the hospital where they can have treatment. He meets Ellie, who's a doctor, and she tends to his injuries. They have a little bit of flirting. He's staying in a boathouse belonging to Frankie, and he starts mentoring the other bouncers and quickly becomes popular with all the locals. There's the gang leader named Dell, who tries to kill him once again, but he is thrown overboard, and then Dalton has got to lift him out of the waters so that he's not killed by a crocodile. Unfortunately, Brandt's father, who's the owner of the entire area, but he's now in prison. He asks Knox, who's a psychotic enforcer goon, to go down and hunt Dalton. And of course, then it's all the problems that comes out because of that. There's big fight scenes. I think the fight scenes between Jake Gyllenhaal and Conor McGregor is very, very brutal. There's a lot of stuff it's a little bit of fun, a little bit of humor thrown in. The romance between Ellie and Dalton is unbelievable. I mean, I didn't really see any point in it first place because it just came out of the blue. I mean, you knew it was going to happen, but it's like, there's no reason for it to actually happen. And she's just like obvious with it. I enjoyed the movie. It's not the best, but it's fun to watch. You can have an afternoon's worth watching it. And it's okay. And inevitably, towards the end, you get to see that the crazy man, Knox, played by Conor McGregor, is actually not dead. He actually comes out. You see his ass a little too much in this movie. I don't even want to watch that anymore. So, yeah. What do I give this film? It's not bad. It's okay. I'll give it a 7 out of 10. It's not the best, but it's good enough to have a watch. Once in a while, Jake Gyllenhaal does a fine job as a hero, and he is ripped in the movie, so you can kind of believe it. Oh, forgot to mention, there's also Travis Manwinkle with a small role, as well as this guy who I've seen quite a bit, Joaquin de Almeida. He is a Portuguese actor who I've seen in several, he's there in a lot of movies. What's he been in? He's very, very, he's very familiar. He was in Downsizing. He was in The Hitman's Bodyguard. He's in the Fast movies, but I've not seen those. He was in Behind Enemy Lines. He was in Desperado as well. Yeah, that's kind of like why he seems so familiar. So yeah, fun action movie that you can watch, but let me tell you, it's not even the greatest. I'll give this movie a 7 out of 10. It's okay. It's something you can, you know, remove your brain off, switch your brain off, and then watch it for the rainy afternoon like it was over here. So that's it. Good night.